chain becoming trivial in that sense. So, okay, so that's good. So we will, what we'll do, when we compute the partition function, I will, because the chemical potentials is what I fix in the partition function, I can choose them to be finite. I will choose them to be finite, and then I don't have to worry about non diagonalizable matrices. Okay, this is a slightly technical step. It's not complicated, but so the idea is that instead of integrating over charges, I will integrate over eigenvalues. That makes the problem far more far easier. Now we need to check that this transformation can actually be done. So this is Q2, Q3, Q4. I will consider n equal 4. I will say, well, it's already here. Why n equal 4 is good? N equal 3 is no good. You have to go to n equal 4. The transformation.
one you get. And so here, little f denotes the semi-classical Virasoro blocks. It's now a function which only depends on the ratios of the operator dimensions and the central charge and with the cross ratio. So essentially, in the semi-classical limit, this block decomposition becomes a sum over of exponentials. And so it is possible to argue under suitable assumptions on the spectrum, OP coefficients and regime range of the cross ratio that it will be dominated by its largest contribution. No, indeed, you need to make also, sorry, for the conformal way. Yes, well, okay, we are already looking at heavy correlators, so that's what I will have in mind. So operators that we scale, like the central charge, yeah. Which H over C is fixed. Okay, so essentially the main idea is that under suitable assumptions this sum can be truncated to one or a small number of terms. And so this has led, indeed, these kind of arguments have led to important results, but at the same time they also raise a number of questions. And so in particular, the following questions that we were interested in is the following. So Virasoro blocks are generically multivalued objects, so they have monodromies as we bring operators one around each other. So let me write that. Is f. And in particular, under certain circumstances, I do not want to enter too much into the details, but the monodromies of these blocks are understood to be in one-to-one correspondence with the existence of multiple geodesic solutions in the dual geometries, if these are available. The values of the blocks on each branches will correspond to different geodesic lengths. So then the question that arises is that essentially what we are doing is approximating a single-valued correlator with a multivalued object. So what we normally do is to give a prescription for how to evaluate this block on a particular sheet. But more in general, we also know that if we were able to perform the full sum, monodromies should recombine into a single-valued correlator. So the question is, how is this single-valuedness restored? And it also has a field theory, a Lagrangian description. So that in this setup, we are able to compute correlators both via a conformal block decomposition and via a path integral. And then we are able then to compare the two and understand in this context how single valuedness is restored. Approximation in this ratio.